Hello and welcome. So for the past 2 weeks, I've been obsessed with these things called painted cakes, and I've barely been able to think about anything else. I'm so distracted by these cakes.
I was so bad that I couldn't remember anything, and I opened up a box of cotton buds and I couldn't remember where I put them. And I even had to look in the fridge, in the freezer. I still don't know where they are.
Oh my God. But don't worry, even if you have no artistic talent at all, these could actually work. Because trust me, I have no artistic talent at all. I'm the daughter of a painter, ironically, and I can't draw.
I mean, even when I was a child, I had such enormous problems colouring within the lines. So the first thing is to find a pattern that you like. Then start tracing the pattern onto the parchment or the tracing paper. It's always best to start practicing on a piece of paper. It's not quite the same as fondant, but it'll kind of give you a good chance to play with the brushes and see how they work. Take the cake and place the paper pencil side against the cake and use the rubber end of your pencil to transfer the pattern. And the key to making pretty flowers and pictures is to have at least 3 layers of colour, from the lightest, like barely able to see colour, to medium to dark. And this helps create a more realistic effect. So you'll be doing 3 layers of colour for these flowers. Just start with some water and a little food colouring. And I test everything on a piece of paper before I touch the cake with the brush. And just using another cavity in the palette, just mix some water with more gel. So make it a little bit darker, but not super dark. And just paint the outside of the flowers and some of the inside with this stronger colour.
The most exciting bit about this all is that if you make a mistake, which you tend to do because that happens, right? You can erase things like a boss. You can delete. Isn't that amazing?
And this is the magic bit where you can actually erase what you've done. So any mistakes that you've made, just by using a clean brush and some water. And I've sort of shown you what it looks like with a like crease in it, because that's not really good, and that's where the colours can get trapped. So you want to avoid having creases or any sorts of dry bits in your fondant. But you just keep dabbing away with it, with the brush and a paper towel, and eventually it will disappear. It may not disappear completely, and you may have to paint over it, but it depends how dark the colours are as well. Yay, we're almost at the end. So just grab your number one brush, which is the thinnest brush, and don't make the mistake that I did of grabbing the wrong brush, and draw an outline in black. Okay, let's not talk about this. I was watching TV and I got distracted, and this happens. And this is a really exciting bit, because once the leaves and the stigmata go on, they really do look like flowers. I admit they don't really look like flowers before them, but once you put the leaves on, they actually look good. Because I can't leave anything well enough alone, I also thought that I should fill in the white gaps with little flowers, and these are really easy to do because you don't need a transfer or a pattern or anything like that. You can draw these freehand, and if I can draw these freehand, trust me, you can. Cleaning brushes is really easy. Always use cold water and then dip them into liquid soap and smooth them into shape. And that's all you have to do. And that's it. Your cake is done. And now I'll show you the list of tools that you'll need to make this cake. And finally, a big thank you to my niece, Natalie, who's almost 6 years old and is so much more adorable than I was. Oh my God, I was not cute at all. I had the daggiest haircut and I don't know. Yeah, not popular in the playground. But that's okay because, you know, I make cakes now and I bribe people to like me. Okay, don't forget to subscribe and let me know if there's anything that you want me to make. See you.